Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Amanda Rose. In today's video, I am going to be talking about all things my hair related. So in the last couple of videos and also on a few posts on Instagram, I'm constantly getting comments about my hair, which I really appreciate because this has been a long journey for me to get my hair back to a healthy state. So I figured that I would just dedicate an entire video talking about all things my hair related. What do I do? What do I not do? What are some of the products that I use? And what have I been using recently that has pretty much grabbed everyone's attention as far as the way that I have been blowing out my hair? So first things first, if you haven't already, please make sure that you subscribe to my channel, that you like this video, and let's get into it, how I've kept my hair healthy. So the first thing I want to talk about is my hair color. This is my natural hair color. I have not dyed my hair in a few years. I always am trying to figure out how long exactly it's been, but I do believe that it's been about 3 years already that I have not dyed my hair. If you guys have seen any of my previous videos, you know that I had my hair blonde for a really long time. And then after blonde, I tried to transition and slowly try to take away some of the blonde out of my hair. And so I had added in a lot of low lights. So I tried to add in my same hair color into the blonde to slowly transition my hair back to my natural color. I had decided to just go back natural. One, I was kind of tired of the blonde. And two, I noticed that every time I would shower, so much of my hair would come out. My hair was coming out in chunks when I would wash my hair, and it really got to the point where I started to get really concerned about the quality of my hair and the quality of my scalp. Also, I suffer from a really, really dry scalp, and I realized that a lot of the shampoos and conditioners that you had to use in order to keep your hair looking really blonde, whether it be purple shampoo or blue shampoos, those things were also drying out my scalp. So I was having a really hard time managing a healthy scalp and also keeping my hair looking really pretty and healthy as well. Also, to be honest, dyeing your hair every couple of months is expensive. I would get the balayage done, and at my local hair salon, I would walk out of there paying $300, sometimes $400, depending on what I had gotten done. For me personally, I just realized, again, with all of the financial goals that I had and wanting to pay off student debt, that dyeing my hair and spending $600-$700, even if it was just a year, was too much money for me to contribute to. So I started that hair journey. So that's the first thing you guys need to know. This right now is my natural hair color. When I was transitioning from the low lights to my full dark hair, I was really annoyed because, again, I had to keep going in and dyeing my hair, adding more brown, adding more brown. So I finally had just told my hairstylist, I'm ready. Dye my whole head, make it as close to my natural hair color as possible, and let's just do this. So we did it, and it was drastic, but I did it. So now I didn't have to worry about anything until that hair color started fading, and then you saw a clear distinction between my natural hair growing in and the dyed hair that looked a lot more reddish brown. So I had to dye it twice, actually, as close to my natural color as possible. Again, this was about 3 years ago. Then what I would do is every time my hair would grow out a little bit, I would just go and get a haircut. So the dyed hair was eventually completely cut off. Now we get to the part where I had severely dry scalp. Still, I'm going to post a picture of the shampoo that I used for about a year that really helped heal my scalp. I have spoken about this in previous videos, and so I can link those videos below if you want to see exactly what it looks like when I shared it in those videos. But this shampoo, one, is quite expensive. I believe it's like $22, but it was the only thing that helped me. It nourished my scalp without making my hair too greasy, and that was something that I really needed. And so I used that again for about a year. I was on that shampoo for a really long time. And the conditioner that I've always been using, even during that time, is this one, the Coconut Milk Conditioner by Organics, by that brand. So I've been using this one. I just like the way it makes my hair feel. I like that it's not heavy. I like that it is sulfate free, which we know that those things are really hurtful for your hair. I've read that this is probably not the best conditioner, but staying away from sulfates is really important for your hair health. I know that it works for me. I know that it doesn't make my hair heavy or greasy. That's another thing. I have really thin hair, so getting conditioners that are too heavy for my hair personally don't work. So I like this one because it is pretty lightweight. Now that my scalp is back to a healthy place, and let's see, because the winter is rolling around, but now I just use the regular like shampoo version of this as well. So I'm kind of addicted, as you will see, to anything that has coconut oil in it. That you've just always learned that it does really good things for your hair, and so I kind of just steer to those things. And I just love the way coconut things smell, so for me, I personally just like using coconut scented stuff. So this is the shampoo that I've also been using as well. It says Damage Remedy Coconut Miracle Oil Shampoo, and so I use this one every time I wash my hair. The next thing I want to discuss is that I do not wash my hair often. I probably wash my hair about twice a week. I've learned that when you wash your hair too much, it does dry out your scalp and it does dry out your hair. Now, what I do in between there is I will use dry shampoo, or I'll put it in a bun or a ponytail, or I'll put it in braids and then I'll just wear it wavy. But I try to do styles that will allow it to last in between washes. The next thing I want to talk about are scrunchies. So these are like fake silk scrunchies. I got them off of Amazon, but I have not noticed any issues with them. So they always advise using silk scrunchies when you are tying up your hair. Now, personally, this is not my style to go outside and use scrunchies like this. I don't sleep with a scrunchie at all. I always sleep with my hair out. I don't sleep with it in a bun or a ponytail, because as you're turning your head, you're also pulling your hair. So I always sleep with my hair out, and what I'll do is, I know it sounds crazy, but it's just become a habit, I will just gather all of my hair up, and let's just say that this is me sleeping on my pillow, and then I'll just put my hair over my pillow. And I've just learned to sleep that way. It's kind of become like a really bad habit, even in the middle of the night, because even as I go to like turn over on another side of the pillow, I like move my hair up. So if people are ever wondering, like, well, do I get dents in my hair and what am I doing with my hair? Like, even when I'm sleeping, I'm lifting it up, I'm laying down, and then I'm constantly just lifting it up and lifting it up. So I never sleep on my hair because I don't want to dent it while I'm sleeping. I know some people put their hair in wraps. Personally, I don't have to do that, but if that's something that you're seeing has worked for you, then doing that at night would be a really good idea as well. So along with that, I do have these packages of these Nourishing Deep Conditioners. I actually haven't used this in a while, but I do have extra in my house for when I was purchasing them often. So this is from, I have no idea how to pronounce it, Manai Coconut Oil Nourishing Deep Conditioner. It says moisturizes and revitalizes for all hair types. So I just would use this. I would use deep conditioners maybe once a week, and I had tried so many. So if you go to your local drugstore, at least in mine, during the hair care section, there's always like the individual packages, and you can purchase an individual package for maybe like $2 or $3, depending on the company. I was obsessed with just buying a bunch of different ones and seeing how my hair would react to those. So I would definitely advise that if you're struggling with dry hair, breaking hair, damaged hair, you may just have to try things out that will eventually work for you. Go and purchase the individual packages and you'll just see if you notice a difference in your hair after using them in the shower. So for me, these are the ones that I stuck with, and again, they were affordable, so I figured why not. Now, the next thing that I want to talk about when it comes to hair health is agua. Now, I hate drinking water. I really don't like drinking water. I know that there are people that really enjoy drinking water. My husband is one of them. Like, he is obsessed with drinking water. For me, I was never a water person. I'm a seltzer water kind of person, but just drinking still water, I was never a fan. However, if you're trying to get your hair back to great health, and if you're trying to help with nourishment and just overall health of your body, water is such a necessity. And so we recently purchased these water bottles, but I just bought something that would help me monitor my water intake. For me, I'm really bad, again, with just keeping track of how much water I drink, and I do use the restroom so often. So that's kind of like the negative, but that has really helped me keep track of my water intake, and it's just so much more convenient than constantly having to like refill a cup of water that you just drink in a second. I've noticed a difference in that. I also think that that's what has added to like the shininess of my hair and just it looking, it just looking healthier. Last thing, finally, is that I don't put a lot of heat on my hair. Now, I know for a lot of people, this is kind of just like the way that you live your life, but I minimize heat when I do blow out my hair. I literally blow out my hair one time a week. After I get out the shower, I'll straighten my hair, and then I'll just constantly, again, re-blow out the crown areas, not every part of my hair. So minimizing heat on your hair is so, so important. Now, when it comes to also how often I cut my hair, I went all of quarantine without cutting my hair, and my hair grew so much, and it was nice to just let it grow out, let it do its thing, and not have to worry about, again, damaging it, putting heat on it. And so I would just say, speak with your hairdresser and do what they advise. Personally, I get a haircut about every 3 months. This finally moves me into the last part, which is how I have been blowing out my hair recently, which leads me to this Revlon brush. I have seen so many videos all over YouTube and Instagram, and even my friends posting this and showing the before and afters of their hair, especially my friends who have curly hair. Wow, like this looks like it does wonders. So I figured that I wanted to try it because why not have a blow dryer and a brush in one, right? Who doesn't want that? So I purchased this, and I will say that I like it a lot. And you guys are going to see a clip in a second of me using it and how I use it to get my hair to look like this. But I do have some positives and negatives about this, and I do want to share them with you guys before I go into the tutorial. Let's talk about positives. The first thing is this dries your hair so quickly. I'm pretty sure that if you're using this, you're going to be able to blow out your hair in probably less than a half an hour. So how quickly and how efficiently it works is really amazing. The second thing about this is that you get to save money again on going out and getting your hair professionally blown out, or I should say professionally straightened. So this specifically was maybe like $40 or $45. And so for me, that's one blowout. So if I can get multiple with the same tool, I think that already you're saving a ton of money. But I do have a lot more cons than I do have positives. The first con I have is that this gets really hot. So there are two settings as far as the heat goes. Well, three technically. There's a cool, there's a low, and there's a high. If you put this thing on high, it gets hot. Hot, okay? Like really, really hot. And I like putting my blow dryer pretty hot. But for me, this got to the point where it felt like I couldn't even like hold my hair because of how hot it was getting. So the reason why I have an issue with that is because, again, I want to keep as little bit of heat on my hair as possible. And so personally, that really scared me. I didn't like how hot it got. The low setting is the setting that I like to use, but I do think that it does take a little bit longer to dry your hair and maybe to get like all the frizzies down. But for me, the high setting is just too hot personally for my hair. It actually like scared me when I felt how hot my hair was. Which gets me to my third con. I think that this works more as like a hair straightener versus a blow dryer. So I know that a hair straightener is going to give you like pin straight hair. But I do think that if you put this on a high setting, your hair is going to look very, very like with a straightener versus the bottom. Because you know sometimes straighteners give you like that edge cut of straight. So this won't give you that just because obviously the edges are rounded. But I will say everything else about it makes it feel, for me personally, like a straightener. It doesn't really give me a lot of volume that a blow dry would do. It does make my hair fall pretty flat like a hair straightener would do. So that was pretty interesting to me when I was using it. I wasn't getting the volume that I wanted like I would normally get from a blow dry, but it was straightening my hair. My third con is how loud it is. The high setting is really, really loud. Unexpectedly loud. And again, it's not a deal breaker. Please don't come for me in the comments. It's just the things that I personally just didn't enjoy. But I didn't like how loud the high setting was. The low setting is definitely doable, but the high setting, especially if you're gonna be right here constantly, like by your ears, you wanna be mindful of that, especially if you have sensitive ears, that this can get really, really loud. And then my last con, which is my fourth, which I think for me is the most important one, is that recently I've been looking at my hair and I've been noticing that I'm getting a lot more flyaways, or I'm getting a lot more breakage at the top of my head. And I'm like, I don't understand. Like, why is that happening to me? Like, why am I getting a lot more breakage? Like, my hair was a lot more smooth just a couple of weeks ago. And it was really stressing me out, right? First world problems. It was really stressing me out because I couldn't figure out why that was happening and what I changed about my routine. Except this thing. This thing is the only thing that I have changed about my routine. So I'm just drawing a conclusion without not many facts. But I'm drawing a conclusion that this might actually be breaking my hair. Now, does my hair look great? I think so, and you'll be able to see it in the video right now. But I do think that this is breaking my hair. I think just from the pulling and not really being able to 100% control what's happening, I do think that is breaking off my hair and giving me all of these little flyaways. So if you are someone who is kind of concerned about that, I am going to recommend the brush that I used prior to purchasing this Revlon thing, and the brush that I will more than likely continue to use and maybe give this Revlon situation, I think I'm gonna shelf it for a second and just see what happens with my hair. But this is the Nanothermic Olivia Garden Brush. And I know there's usually like sizing. I know this one says NT54. But this is, again, it was a pretty expensive brush, maybe like $25. But I've been using this to blow out my hair, and I've been using this all of quarantine. So all those videos during quarantine where it was like, whoa, love the way your hair looks. This is what I've been using. So if you're afraid of adding any more breakage, or if you do have this Revlon brush and you're like, I never thought about that, but I am seeing more and more breakage in my hair, you may want to put that down for a second and just go back to the old school blow dryer and brush for a second and see what works for you. So hopefully this is helpful for you guys. This is the brush that I was always using before purchasing this, and I can 100% stand by this brush. I love the way my hair looks with it. It did take some time getting used to because I'm not used to these types of bristles, but 100%, I love the way that my hair looks with this, the way that my hair felt, and I never had issues with breakage. So that's pretty much it. That's everything about my hair. And now I'm going to show you guys a hair tutorial using the Revlon brush. Okay, so I'm going to show you guys what my hair looks like now. So I know it's also really hard to tell because my hair is black. The last time I did a video like this, my hair was blonde. So you can just see that it was wet or see the dimension in my hair. But when it's all one color, it's really hard to see that stuff. So honestly, the point of this is just to give my hair a little bit more body because it just gets really flat if I just use the dryer on its own. I feel like for this specific item, and I guess this should be more of like a review, but I do think that this item just like does a really good job at making your hair straight, but not necessarily at like making it seem like you have like a blowout. I do think that there is a really big difference. So I still like to use a brush and I still like to use the, that one's hard to take out. I still like to use a brush and I still like to use the clips because I do think that it gives it more of like that blowout look versus just having it straight. But I think for people who have curly hair and your hair is straight, you may actually really, really like this because I think that it just takes a lot of the work out of it for you and you get to do a really good job at straightening your hair. So let me take these out. I will say I was kind of messy. I was kind of like rushing with the clips. So I want to be careful that I don't pull my hair. I'll have one more. There we go. Okay. So I'm going to just run my fingers through. I have a mirror here, so I just want to look at my mirror really quick and then comb it through because I still like for it to look, again, like bouncy, like a blowout, but not necessarily like super like wavy at the bottom. Okay, so let me just move a little closer. I wonder if I can make it brighter. Somehow you could see my hair better. But this is what it looks like. So some people I've seen online, they're able to get this look with just the brush. Personally, for whatever reason, with my hair, I can't. I have to use an additional tool, but it's not like I'm doing additional heat on the hair. It's just adding a different tool to kind of give my hair that like full out blowout look that I really like. But yeah, really good. Quick, easy, and yeah.